How goes?
Aurok's Shadow, what's that wicked thing doing here? It's a killer! Look, we don't want no trouble, just trying to do our work. We'd be much obliged if you'd leave us be, and take that thing with you. Everyone does. Let the Raid Sarens into the Deerwood. What's that got to do with anything? Just a woodcutter. Ask anyone in Stalwart. They'll tell you.
What did you say?
Let's see.
almost 15 years I've been looking for him. All that fretting and wondering. And the deed's over in less time than it takes to tell. Peace. Now there's a funny word for it. I killed a lot of folk in my time. Felt their blood slick in my hands. Smelled their flesh as it burned. And I always used to imagine what it would be like to have Harmka under my knife. Feeling his breath come hot and fast. Smelling the fear ooze out of him. Couldn't feel a thing. His fading pulse weren't no more than a patter of rain to me. This body, it weren't made for feeling. Gouging my fingers into Harmka's wasting flesh, his screams just buzzing in my skull. All it did was remind me that this is a madman's fever dream. Like a prison, but no, because in a prison, you lay your head down and you feel the straw soft beneath you. Your flesh prickling in the cold, black bread crumbling on your tongue. I still dream I'm folk. I wake up some mornings wondering why I can't feel the floor beneath me, thinking I must have fallen and gone crippled. But then I lift my head, see a bronze corpse stretching out in front of me. It's not pity I want, it's a choice. I dream too of what Galvino did that night. Those moments. I'd endure another cold morning if it had spared me this fate. Was after I got caught in Stalwart. They'd locked me in a little house by me and the old mayor and his cronies. When a crowd of them came for me in the dark of night, I was only surprised it had taken them so long. Only they didn't march me to no gallows. No, they stuck me to another house on the edge of town, real sneaky-like. That's where I met Galvino. He was fiddling with some machinery in his workshop. Had his sleeves rolled up, even though it was cold enough to see your breath. Never actually looked at me until he started fitting some copper helmet over my head. By that time, the mayor's goons had me trussed up good and tight. Galvino was having himself a grand time barking orders at that lot. So while Galvino's fastening that helmet over my head and them copper bands around my arms, I'm starting to look at his contraption. And that's when I see it. It's this metal suit strapped into the machine, just like me. A cold, dead-eyed thing, all done up with fancy carvings and such. I had this terrible cold feeling in my gut, but I still couldn't figure. I start asking Galvino and the rest of them what's going on, but they're too busy to answer. Then suddenly, they're waiting, staring at me with that fixed, horrified look. But they ain't watching me. They're watching for something to happen. Galvino tells the woman nearest the machine to flip the handle. And then, just pain. Being torn apart every which way, feeling my soul peeled from my body. By the time I came to, I couldn't feel a thing. Just this dull, distant sort of ache. That was when I knew. Sure enough, and how Galvino ended up in that little shack. The rest of Stalwart didn't take kindly to having a killer in their midst, nor to seeing their mayor and the army of aliens strike a secret deal. They drove Galvino out, destroyed a fortune in machinery, and wrote a letter to the Academy in Salona, ruining what was left of his name. Still, he's lucky he didn't get a pelting. The old mare fled too, and Stalwart's been as snug and cheery as ever. You're better company than Galvino. Been a while since I were out in the world. Guess I'm keen on seeing more of it. Even if I'm stuck with a bleeding heart. Anyways, I've been wondering about that fortress. Near everyone thinks it'll have just the thing they need. Those villagers want it to fix up their brook downtown. Galvino always thought it carried some great secret of Animanson. And all them adventurers came looking for fancy gear.
Yeah. Maybe.
I just figured, with those dwarves being expert smiths and all, maybe they had something to unmake me. Put me back into my body. You really think so, huh? Well, ain't like you to blast hot air.
That caravan must have had a half ton of steel. Coinmaster Zoltan's finally getting his way.
For now, the other commandants will have his head.
Only if they don't tear each other to pieces first. I heard Maroon and Exandru.
Last thing I want is to get on Maroon's bad side.
Fine, just say the words then. I'm getting hoarse.
It definitely looks deserted.
I hear them. Whispering of long dead memories. They're here, Watcher.
We earned this. Durgan's steel has lined our halls in gold.
Your vanity dishonors Abidun and cheapens us all.
These weapons are ours. Or have you two forgotten how to hold a sword?
Did anyone else see talking spirits?
If you say so, that'll do.
Damn you both! My generation built this keep to honor Abidun, not to further your greed and ambition.
We're Pergrunan. Our forefathers explored and conquered, but you've stuck us in this frigid hall.
Paved with gold and marble! I won't allow us to abandon our legacy for your delusions.
No, you'll peddle it away to line your pockets. How much have you made selling our steel, Zoltan?
Again with your lies. You think I don't hear you turning the others against me? These walls echo, and...
Enough. I'll send the Forge Guardians on both of you if that's what it takes.
If you say so. Got it done. Ain't that special?
He's a traitor to the battery.
If you say so, that'll do.
She'll bring these walls down around us. Before the Commandants come to blow.
Did you see the look in Maroon's eye? Exandro had better watch his back.
Sheet sold our steel and kept the coin himself.
Maroon! She won't rest until our corpses decorate the halls!
Let's go! Found something. Let's go!
Got it done.
Worth a look. Let's go!
Got it done.
Found something. Let's go!
That'll do.
Let's go! Let's go!
We've got to survive, by any means necessary.
We'll have blood in these halls before long.
Stop right there. You must be some merchant come to speak with Zoltan. Our illustrious coin master may let you plunder our armory, but I've got other ideas for dealing with your lot. Turn and go before I show you how an arms warden deals with trespassers. Pargrun and Quarles are no business of yours, outsider. I'm Maroon, proud Pargrun and arms warden of Durgan's battery. And you're answering my questions now. leave our halls. Go back to whatever land you hail from. You waste your breath on hollow threats. I'll have you carved by Durgan steel, wretch. Then we'll see what the other commandants have to say.
Let's go!
Got it done.
We can't hold them off!
Fall back!
Thank were that...
If you say so. Got it done. If you say so.
They're coming! To the mines!
Leave no
Found something.
My mind feels sharp as steel.
You gotta see this.
Gears. They're coming!
This one repels me.
Ruach 10!
Thank you.
You hear that?
Are we safe here?
Stop him!
Blasphemy! These are Abidun's treasures!
Let's go!
You profane!
Thank you.
together. We're in this together.
I'll organize the troops to guard the stairs. We can hold them off for a while.
Vazel's repairing the Guardians. Elune's preparing for the...
You can't be serious about this. Let's just wait those monsters out. Abidun wouldn't let us...
Abidun rewards earnest work, not begging and cowering. We must hurry.
We'll hold them off as long as we can.
Thank you.
Abidan, guide us. Strengthen us with your flame, Lord Abidan.
Temper us for the crucible.
Stand ready, Commandants!
We'll give ourselves for the battery.
If you say so.
Got it done.
If you say so,
that'll do.
Stand your ground.
Fetch our best
weapons.
They must stand up to the heat.
If you say so.
Let's go.
Right away,
let's go.
Quickly, there's not much time.
Alone, we've never introduced this much essence into the White Forge.
Belong to us, to the Pargrunin.
You would steal from us, from the
Abidun himself. You will regret your trespass.
Ain't that special?
Let's go! Found something.
If you say so.
The Guardians will hold the door as long as need be.
Everyone else is ready. So few of us remain.
Lord Abidun, guide our hands and steel our hearts. Give us the mercy of your fall.
Dare you to stick your head in there?
Stirs in the heart of the battery.
Heat. Tremors. They return.
Remember yourselves, Pargrunen! Defend the battery!
Ah, thanks.
Thank you.
I'd gladly shoulder the load, but the pack won't hold it.
Something else you need?
Did you see that dwarven woman? Oh, hips like a church bell.
Now you want me to be that friend? I can't help you with women, Kana.
As you like. She was making eyes at you the whole time, so I thought.
Maybe just point her out next time you see her.
Hey, how's that song go again? The one you were singing a minute ago?
North and home again? Just getting into the mountain spirit. I'll keep it to a hum, if you like.
No, it was nice. In fact, you could sing it some more, if you want.
Thank you.
And then you hit your own father?
Not I. That was Isselmir.
Yeah, but you're the same person.
Fighting cock's feathers to that!
I see your point.
Yourselves, soldiers!
Is this safe, Curate Ilun?
You gotta see this.
It's necessary.
Stop, Marauder! Our bodies are dust already. Must you profane holy ground with further violence? Did the height of our walls offend you? Did we cross your borders? Sail you weak steel? Tell us, why did you invade our fortress? No, that cannot be. Abidan wouldn't allow it.
Wake up, Exandru! This is why Avowed gave us the White Forge, that we might take up arms and deal with villains like this.
Such a magnificent device, and she can only see it as a tool for war. She shames our grandparents, who wandered this continent and... Quiet, both of you! Can't you feel it? This chill. This silence. But you... You entered our keep and found it abandoned. Ruined. What happened to us? I'd never seen anything like them. Twice the size of any ogre, and positively fearless. They were...
Eyeless. Yet no matter how hard we fought, or how deep we hid, they kept coming for us.
Some kind of magfolk, but bigger than any we knew of. We who survived never got close.
They were relentless. Unnaturally so. We should have taken our steel and pushed east.
What's to say they didn't come from the east? From the lands Maroon so coveted? It was a punishment for taking this gift of Abidan, the White Forge, and squandering it on our greed and vanity.
We retreated until there was no place left to go. Until those of us who remained were here.
Here, with the salvation Abidan had left us. Yes, using the same methods with which we had fashioned so much cold steel. It was agony. Feeling your soul ripped from your flesh. Feeling every part of you torn asunder. But it saved us.
Imprisoned us.
It was Abidun's grace. Now, we inhabit the monument our people built to the White Forge. The White Forge belongs to Abidan, of course. It is here that he built his own body. And whether he found this place or created it, it's a truly remarkable smithy. We Pargrunin are wanderers by nature, but it was Abidan's call that led our forefathers here, after generations spent along the Pearl Coast and Air Glonfoth.
So the old stories say. Then again, I can't see any other reason our grandfathers would have stayed here when greener lands lay east.
Its fires have been blessed by Abidan. They're fed by Aeora's molten heartbeat and veined with Audra that runs to the center of the world.
Which explains their conductive power. See, these Audra veins allowed us to siphon essence into steel as we shaped it.
And that essence, the extraordinary heat of the forge, and our smith's skill is what made Durgan's steel so remarkable. Stuck here, you mean, with all the others who sought to escape the Eyeless. Had we thought longer on the fate that awaited us, we might have chosen a quick death to this slow agony.
Blasphemy! There's no greater honor than remaining here, watching over the White Forge. I only wish we could protect this humble monument better.
Or do something. Anything. We were once among the greatest smiths in the known world. Tell me, do Kith still speak of us? That is good to know. It's only a shame that this legacy is nothing but a memory.
Is this why you braved the restless souls of Durgan's battery? To recover the process of Durgan's steel? I hope you're satisfied with what you found here.
At least you get to leave this place.
But it was good to be remembered, however briefly.
By the time you stepped out of Durgan's battery and into the new snow outside, word had already spread of strange lights rising from the fortress and energy crackling in the sky. The survivors of Starwart flocked to Durgan's battery, their steps hastened by the promise of peace and prosperity at last. They mended their walls, gathered their strength, and prepared their town for the new opportunities that were sure to come. And with the voices of Durgan's battery silent at last, none heard the distant groan of something stirring among the peaks, as massive and relentless as an avalanche.
This place, as beautiful as it can be with the absence.
While we wait, the enemy grows stronger.
And you'd send more of us to die.
Well, I'm not gonna stand around. Are you?
You've done plenty, Darian.
It's been a week since our people left these gates. A week since the Iron Flail took them. Yet we wait here behind our sturdy new walls, hiding in our rebuilt homes. We've done nothing. And since I got here, I've been working alongside the rest of you. Don't start with that again.
Well, it was your idea to send our people to that damned fort in the first place. If it weren't for you and the other leeches that come up with you, we wouldn't be in this mess.
Enough. Enough. You want to boot all the Outlanders from your town? Tell that to the hero of the White Forge.
Then you know about the Iron Flail. You'll stop them?
Showed up a few weeks after you opened the battery. Demanded we give them the White Forge. They're led by a Darik Sendamir. Comes from an old Raid Saren family. Rumor has it the man's half mad with visions. Claims one drove him here to take the White Forge.
They're not the only bloodsuckers around here.
Our crew at the battery locked their doors and told the Iron Flail to go back to Raid Saris. Instead, they built a fort in the middle of the wood. So we sent a committee to reason with them. But that was a week ago. We haven't seen our people since. That can only mean one thing.
We're just miners and fisher folk.
Send Darian and the rest of the newcomers. Let them earn their keep.
We've cleared your roads and repaired this town. What more do we have to prove?
Maybe we could nudge them into torching their own village.
Please, everyone. Whatever our differences, we've got to deal with the army at our gates. You've done a lot for Stalwart already. Many of us wouldn't even be here if it wasn't for you. What I mean is, if anyone could deal with an army, it's you. The Iron Flail cleared a patch of forest north of Durgan's battery, built their fort there. It'll be well guarded, so if you can get in without raising an alarm, you may have an easier time of it. The important thing is to deal with the commander. If you can get rid of him, the rest of the soldiers will scatter. Anyway, we've got our work cut out for us here. While you're out, stop by the battery. Wangra and her team are still repairing the heavy cannons. They've made a lot of progress elsewhere. Thought you might like to see how far it's come.
Don't see many on these roads, and the few we do are hunters, woodcutters, or smugglers. And here I was, thinking we'd found the last pleasant company on the road. I'm after him, all right. He's going to answer for his crimes in Raid Saris, and one way or another, you're going to stay out of my way. Didn't tell you that part, did he? First off, he chose his indentureship. Had to make up for some bad luck at cards, I hear. More importantly, he murdered his master's son, 13-year-old boy, killed him as he fled. I figured that might be the case. Trouble is, I can't let you warn him. But don't worry, I got other uses for you. Nice, strong fellow like you do well in the lumber yards. I know a few along the border that'd pay well.
out.
I ain't heard a voice like yours in quite a while. Quite a spell, Connor. What got you into chanting?
You know, I'm not certain. It's good as breathing now. Perhaps my mother sang one too many hymns over her belly.
Mine taught me how to gut a rabbit and skin it in one piece. I guess that explains a few things.
Thank you. progress with Devala? And I thought you were going to get rid of Devala, not sell me out to her. What she said is true. I had a gambling problem when I was younger. I've paid 7 years of my life for it. I won't pay any more. As for the boy, I didn't want to hurt him. But he saw me as I was sneaking out of the stockade. I wish it had gone differently. But I'd do it again. Anything to keep from getting sent back to that place. It's not a yoke around my neck. And I suppose it's better than dying in this frozen crater of a town.
I must say, I'm impressed.